Hello and welcome. I am Count Christo, this is Hearts of Iron 4, and this is the Polite Poland playthrough. I just remembered that we've still got these fighters, which I think we will have gloriously fight and die over the skies of Western Poland as the war begins and the Germans flood in with hugely more fighters than we could possibly hope to put in. What I think we'll do is have them fly just day missions, and we'll just see what they can do to help. So the Germans just got cores on some of our land, and they may be about to begin justifying war goals against me. But they haven't yet. That's a good sign. Hopefully they will continue to not do so. Now, they can demand the Sudetenland, but they just get a claim on it for that, and they get a conquer focus against us. So that will be when they declare war on us. If they do demand the Sudetenland, that will give them a focus war goal against us, and I think the AI always takes focus war goals. Okay, so we just got modernizing the cavalry, which is excellent. That means I can research a cavalry tech, or not a cavalry tech, excuse me, a motorized tech. I think I'm going to actually switch off doing excavation to do I keep calling them cavalry, to do motorized, which only takes 22 days, which is fantastic. So let's get that done. These guys are still gearing up. That's good. How long's the deficit now on infantry? Only 170 days, that's good. I keep thinking of things, you know, 170 days, that's about two and a bit focuses that Germany can do in that time. That's that's how time seems to be now. It's all number of German focuses. I'm going to put some of the weaker divisions on the Soviet front. I think that makes sense, because I just want them there beginning to build up a little bit of, whatchamacallit, entrenchment. I quite like the flag, by the way, with the old Polish eagle in the middle. I think that looks very cool. Okay, now we're going to rush down to field hospitals, because we are a low manpower nation in this game. In other words, we're a nation that's not the Soviets, India, or China. The war still rages, incidentally, in China. It looks like Japan slowed down. It could be a Chinese win. That would be pretty cool. In fact, we could send volunteers to China. We have very low numbers of troops at the moment, but I'm tempted to send volunteers to China. How many could we send if we sent them right now? Send volunteers. We could send three. I'm tempted. It would give us something to do. Shall I send volunteers? I don't know. We've got lots more coming in. Yeah, go on, let's send some volunteers to China. Okay, you five. And I pick them for no particular reason, except they're the good type. We're going to give them the Field Marshal. Should I do that? No. The Field Marshal needs to stay here because he's giving everyone an entrenchment bonus. I don't want them to have to rebuild that up because of his absence. Instead, I'll give them... let's give them a general, in fact. A reconnaissance general. That seems fine. Actually, I said three, not five, didn't I? Oops. Let's put two of them back. There we go. So these three, let's send them over. Hey, China. We're totally on your side. It's funny, it says we'll generate 1.7% threat, which is a bit of a throwback to Hearts of Iron 3, when threat was a mechanic that existed, unlike in this game. Which doesn't have a concept of threat, it only has, you know, world tension. Now, Hungary is quite likely to join the Axis at some point, but I can't yet afford to garrison their border. We will want to do that at some point. As you can see, they have quite a lot of divisions down there in Hungary, 44 to 77. So they're going to be a problem. There's our improved infantry equipment. In 8, what else do you need to get in 8? Oh yes, we need to get the... Well, actually no, we get that one once this focus finishes. Let's get the other basic infantry equipment one. Okay, there goes another 8 troops from there. Okay, the volunteers have arrived. Let's slow down time. What I think, how we can best contribute to this war is helping push back along this coast and retaking, because lots of this is very valuable industrial heartland for China. So we're going to put a front line like that and see if we can push back there. That seems good to me. Oh, we can modify the government again. Let's go for... Tank designer could be good. War industrialist. Yeah, yeah. War industrialist sounds good. We're doing almost nothing but produce military factories at the moment, so I think he'll definitely come in handy. Just going to speed up time while they reach the front and then slow it down again so we can do some proper command. Maybe we should try and cut in. Yeah, that sounds good. Let's see if we can... We're going to see if we can cut in like this to that port there. Let's have them strategically redeploy. Oh, although we can't allow them... Yeah, change of mind. We can't allow them to take this port. Ooh. Okay, walk in. Slow down. You can't retract volunteer forces, by the way, until the war is over, get declare war on. So there's no way we're going to be able to pull these guys back unless we go to war. I think maybe we try and hold this line for a moment. This feels too unambitious. Yeah, let's not do that. Let's push like this. Okay, they're quite quick divisions. Can we get there in time? No, we can't. But we can attack without them having any kind of entrenchment, which is pretty nice. Let's have you do the same thing. There's some volunteers from the Soviets helping China out, as they often do, and as they should. It's very, very useful for the Soviets if China wins this war. Not least because with a little bit of boosting party popularity, you can quite simply get lots of this land to be handed over to the communist China. Let's see if we can push in. Oh, no. We need to reinforce that port if we can. So let's have him come down here. In fact, let's have him on this now, but yeah, get to that port as soon as you can. Nothing really is going to change at home. If Germany starts fabricating a war goal against us, which they'll need to do before they can declare war, or if they do this focus, we're going to get a pop-up telling us that they're fabricating a war goal against us. So we're not going to get caught unaware or anything. I'm just going to force these guys to spread out a bit more sensibly by moving them off the province. That should work. And I think they will then spread out, right? No? Okay, how about if I spread you out? A bit manually. Will that work? Let's see. Really should spread out better on its own. But oh, thank goodness, China. Well done. Fortifying the border with France. That's an important priority right now. The AI needs a little bit of work, but it's not that bad. It's not as bad as lots of people make it out to be. Alright, I'm going to try and immediately retake that province. Pushing into the mountains doesn't seem smart. How did we just lose? Our organisation's still really high. Nonsense. Go back again. As soon as more divisions keep deploying, by the way, we're going to be able to send more and more volunteers. Yep, so we can send one more there, see. Send this guy. Put him into a new army. And then we'll be able to ship him over to China. Oh, we could join the Chinese faction, that'd be funny. But no, we're not going to do that. We are independent Poland. We are polite Poland. I think it's... Oof. Don't really want to push into mountains there. But if we can push in before these guys arrive, that'd be good. Study foreign tanks is done. That's good. I think the defence of Poland is a very important focus. We need to get our land doctrine up as quick as we can. Let's spread out a bit here. Like that. Hold this port. Yeah, I'm not feeling so good about pushing potential here. When our other guy arrives, that'll be helpful, but yeah, we're looking very low on lots of this equipment. Oop, no. We don't want to push into mountains, if at all possible. We want to avoid that. Go on, shift. There we go. They're trying to push in south, but we've got a great defence these days. No, they got in there. Let's see if we can do it with a support attack. It looks like they strategically redeployed to here. Yeah, looks like we're winning that one. Good. One of the good reasons to do things like volunteers is because you get lots of land army experience from doing this, which is good. Just from fighting anywhere, you get experience, which is very nice to have. There's our extra guy, good. Bring him up here, widen the front a bit, since we can now afford to. I think I'll have him. Also, of course, your troops get more experienced. Although, since they don't have any field hospitals, every time someone dies, they get a little bit less experienced. Obviously, makes sense. Field hospitals, which we're currently researching, decrease the amount that happens by 10%. They also give you 20% trickle back, so people that die in combat actually don't die, they just go back into the manpower pool, which is very useful. When you fully upgrade them, I believe they give you 50% trickle back, which is fantastic. And some superb medicine, if you think about it. 50% of everyone thought dead somehow manages to survive. It's really quite impressive. That push in the south's not going as well as it could. With that, can we get there first? They're there in 1 day and 1 hour. We're there in 2 days. No, they can't, but we can support them in that attack down there. Ooh, but now we're getting attacked, so counterattack. Counterattacking in this game is very useful, because if you can give them that in multiple combats penalty, it's very useful. The Soviets are helping out, so let's push in. How are the Soviet divisions? This is a good time to spy on the Soviet division. Not very good. Oh well. Okay, there's prepared defence, that's good. Now, the defence opponent focus isn't done for a while, so I will use this slot for something other than just going straight down to that one. It's May of 98. What do I want to do? Ah yes, we've got the tank bonus, don't we? Yes, great. So I can get the 7 TP in just a short 80 days. Ooh, that's getting tricky. Okay, let's get him out of the multiple combats penalty. And let's move these guys round one, I think. A good strategy at this point. That push really isn't going as well as I'd like. Ooh, but if they draw someone out, it could go a lot better. Ha ha ha! Retreat from that one, I think. There we go. So that one should be able to hold now. And now we can send one in there, and one in there. Oh, I should have held him there and used the other one to get the pullback. So yeah, this is a great way to get army experience, which is very useful for template modification, of course. There's the computing machine. We want decryption as soon as possible. It's very useful for seeing seeing what your enemy's up to. They're still doing army innovations. See, Germany would be quite happy to let us into their faction right now, as would China. But unfortunately, well, fortunately, I think, so it'll make it more fun, but unfortunately for our short-term survivability, that would be breaking the rules. Yeah, looks like we're going to push in there this time. Take that port back. Fantastic. That's great. And down they go. And now you can go back up there. You can pin them so that he can get into the port in time. Just a couple of hours of a losing fight in order to get him in there. That's good. Ooh, it's a tricky battle, but it looks like we're going to pull it out. Fantastic. Support that attack. Might be able to push beyond the port. No. Let's not waste good Polish lives. Almost a German. No. Germans are the arch enemy. Got to adjust from the previous campaign. There we go. So we've pocketed these guys. Let's punish them for it. Oh, but they're pushing back hard. Ouch. Oh, here comes some units from... what's that flag? Which of those is that? It's Manchukuo, I think. That's how you say that, looks like. We're holding here, okay. I'm going to let them build up a preparation bonus, I think, before I push again with these guys. But look at the speed that's building up. That's great. And, of course, it's to 80%, which is a huge bonus. Every attack you make with a unit with 80% preparation bonus does 80% more damage, more soft attack. It's just amazing. Does it do 80% more hard attack as well? Yes, it does. 80% more soft and hard attack. That's marvellous. Without exaggeration, that's a really, really, really powerful modifier. Let's push up here with the two divisions. It's going quite well. And let's retaliate. When someone attacks you and loses all their organisation in the attack, it's often a good idea to counter-attack, because they've no organisation to resist you with. Let's not let ourselves become susceptible to that tactic here. looks like we can push into that one now. Yeah, good. I said I'd let us wait to get the planning bonus. Didn't do that, did I? No. One of the reasons I'm not training on this front, even though now we have a fair amount of infantry equipment, is that they could attack us. Ooh, there it is. There it is. Ladies and gentlemen, they're going to demand the Sudetenland, which gives them... Germany gains a conquest focus war goal against phalangist Poland. That's pretty bad, guys. That's pretty bad. Although I haven't... Oh, this is interesting. That's very interesting. Okay, they're going to do this before they do the Malentrov-Ribbentrop Pact. That's right, isn't it? They haven't done that yet. No, they haven't done that yet, or they would both have a modifier. That's really interesting. That might mean that they're not going to... These guys aren't going to be able to declare on us, because they haven't got all their claims on us. Interesting. Because they don't... They get... where is it that they demand Eastern Poland? There it is. And they're still all the way up here. So we've got a long time before they get all the way down here. Interesting indeed. Okay, well, let's see what we can do in China before we get kicked out. Because it's not long before we get kicked out. Let's extend this line a bit, since we've got a spare guy. But I'm excited. War is about to break out. Very shortly, war was declared. Okay, I'm going to cancel these guys, because I want to have a bit of a surplus, equipment-wise, once war breaks out. I would like... more military factories. There we go. Maybe even more. There we go. Ooh, it's getting tense. It's getting tense. We're holding right over here. Oh, you know I said you couldn't take these troops back. That's true, but you can delete them. And remember that deleting them gives you all their equipment and all their manpower, as long as they're not pocketed. By pocketed, I mean in circles. So that's a good thing to remember, that you can't technically kind of just withdraw them, but you can get them back, or at least you can get all the equipment back. Now, is there a some kind of focus that gives us any actual bonus defense on home territory? You sometimes get those in these kind of things. Doesn't look like it. Another 50% bonus for land doctrine would be good, but we've got time before that. 28 days until that one. Tank's invented, so we should probably push straight to the next tank. Yeah, let's go straight to the next tank tech, because I want the medium tanks invented before I start with the with the thing. They may not declare on us, but I think it's almost certain that they will, as soon as they can. We appear to be holding this front for China quite nicely. They certainly wouldn't if we weren't here. We're just getting lots of army experience out of this, basically. You can see that's ticking up at significantly more than 0.5 daily. Oop, they overextended too much there. There's the 7TP. Let's invent some signal companies, I think. I want to get more support equipment than this, because I want to be able to kind of just instantly add in lots of lots more support divisions. Oh, no, they reinforced there in time. Darn it. Not that our pushes in this area really matter, because we're very shortly going to be pulling these troops back. But, you know, might as well fight the battle you're in. So, I think getting more encryption is wise. Now, I'm thinking, if they can't do demand Eastern Poland, right? That's the moment at which we need troops on this front. So actually, I'm going to pull back all these troops, put them on this front, because we don't need lots and lots of troops over here at the moment, because they've no way of actually declaring war on us without us having a warning. So I'm going to do that. and pull them all the way back over to here. Let's spread these out a bit more sensibly. As I recall, there's one of these provinces which is plains, and they often push through it. Where is it? No, it looks like it's all hills. All hills. Yeah, that one is hills without fort, though. Ooh, and we've got some good anti-air around here. Ooh, fantastic. That's going to be very helpful. That's going to shoot down lots of German planes. I'm not happy. Not happy about that demand Sudetenland. Sudetenland. Focus. I think I should probably focus over here again. I'm going to be short of... Ooh, we're very short of steel. I should have noticed that earlier. Darn it, darn it, darn it, darn it, darn it. The other problem is we're trading, like, through here, right? And as soon as this goes to enemy, that means that trade can no longer pass through it. So we're not going to be able to trade with them. So we might have to start trading with only Finland, Sweden, these guys, and the Soviets. Which is not great. Do they have a... Where do they get their claims on these guys from? I think that's actually from the Molotov-Ribbentrop Pact. So they're not actually going to get those, which is great news for us. Okay, here we go. We're getting there. I'm just going to keep an eye on this defences thing. If we just stand and defend, that's the cheapest way to get army experience without actually costing yourself many people. Fourth International. So the Soviet Union is exerting some communist influence abroad, is what that means. France and Britain announce an alliance. That's good. Okay, there it is. They've got their claim on us. They've got a conquest war goal. Let's see if they use it. They shouldn't use it right now, because they've left all these provinces undefended, which I'll happily take from them. But they're reorganising troops on our front. I think... Ooh, we've got enough to... I think I'll go up to limited conscription. We're getting slightly low on manpower. Ooh. I can feel it. I can just feel the attack coming. They're reasserting eastern claims. The one that comes after that is Danzig or war. Maybe they won't declare war on us because we're on historical focus. I'm not sure. Soviet withdrawal. That's interesting. Spread out. These guys, I don't know why they're so bad at spreading out. Maybe it's because I'm deploying them too close to the front line. Let's have them deploy... Well, there's only two left, so it won't make much difference. But let's have them deploy back here and see if they still go to that province. There we go. Spread them out a bit myself. Ooh, got a free tech slot. How long is it until cruiser tank experiments? Only another 8 days, so I'm going to hold on to that tech slot until that moment comes. How do you feel about your plan? Still no superior enemy modifier, which I'm very pleased about. There's the cruiser tank experiments. I'm going to get the Roman bridgehead strategy next. Sorry, did that say Roman or Romanian? Probably not Roman, now I think of it. Yeah, Romanian. I wonder what that strategy means. We're going to attack Romania? It seems unlikely. Okay, probably don't need three there. Three here would be better. You go there. This really is minutiae at this point, spreading out each individual group, but I think it's probably worth it. You go there. So it looks like they're not going to attack us. Pause for a second, just to allow some Sod's Law immediate attack. Oh no, they fortified this pocket. I was hoping they weren't going to fortify this pocket at all, which would have made it much easier on us in the beginning if we could just sweep up this pocket for free. But since they have fortified it, I'll divert more troops to it. Oh, that's a lot of troops lining up on our borders. Chinese volunteers still okay? Yeah, looks like it. Looks like they're still doing fine down there. Cool. Okay, well, we've got... So, how much would it cost to switch all of the rest of those poorer guys to these? Far too much. How about, how much would it cost to switch these guys to my water divisions? 4,000 infantry equipment. See, we can afford to do this pretty cheaply. Let's do it. Let's do it. To the water divisions. That does kill our experience a little bit, but that's okay. Ooh, put some of them down to green. Okay, that was a mistake. I shouldn't do it for anyone that it puts down to green. We can't afford to have any green divisions. I'm going to have these guys exercise their way back up. Yeah, no, that was a big mistake. Shouldn't have done that. It shouldn't take them very long to get back up, though. They're gaining, 2.47 a day. That's very quick. Oh yes, now I can do the another tech. What should I get next? I think I'm going to take this ahead of time, because we want to get producing that as soon as possible. Oh! There's the war, just when we were doing some training. That's horrendous. Okay. Here it is. The beginning of the war. Right, let's push on this front, because I want these troops free over here. Oh no! So many of our divisions have low organization because of that mistake. Well, these fights look bad, but actually, they're much better than it's claiming, because look at those defense values. Okay, let's slow it right down. Let's manually push in the north here. We need to blitz in here at maximum speed, with no hesitation. Like that. How are those going to go? Okay, all those attacks are looking good. I think all these numbers will improve. How's that one, actually? Yeah, see, 700 defense. Okay, I'm going to push a bit in the south, since they've left all these provinces open to us. Which is very nice of them, really. No, stay there. Okay. So yeah, there's no war between England and Germany. But I think what Germany's going to do is that's going to immediately bypass this, and then they're going to do around the Maginot, which means they'll declare war on Belgium and the Netherlands, and that will draw them into war against England and France. Ooh, but until then, that's not a good number. Let's see, all those water divisions are retreating. No. Such a silly mistake. Never have units training on the front line, ever. It's a terrible idea. I mean, when the enemy is, you know, just about to attack you. It's a terrible, terrible mistake. Well, we'll see if we can recover. Let's pull back one province. We might have to pull back a bit here. I'm still feeling good, though. They're doing a naval invasion of Danzig. That's an interesting idea. Invite to faction. I'm sorry, England. I'm sorry. It's very generous of you. And, you shouldn't take my declining as an indication of anything, but no, we will not join your faction. Ooh, look, they've left themselves open down here. Let's, should we push? We've got these forts. Oh no, there's not many forts down here, actually. Yeah, let's push a bit. If they're going to give us land, we might as well take the land. I mean, I won't say no. Especially if I can push to a mountain province rather than a woods province. Certainly won't say no to that. So it looks like we've held fine everywhere except just here. Which is painful, but I think I'll have to hold that retreat, that attack. And I can't hold... You don't want to hold a province that can be attacked from this many directions, ideally. So I think we'll have to fall back a bit there. But that's okay, that shortened our line. That's never a bad thing. Well, it's always sometimes a bad thing. It's not a bad thing in this circumstance. Okay, that's good. Looks like we're going to be able to kill that. And as soon as we kill that unit, then we're going to be able to close that pocket up pretty quick, because they'll have no supply. Let's see if we can shorten the line down here. That's looking good. I generally want to keep this bit of the line a bit more static, because there's forts there. I don't want to push into plains, that's sure. I would like to push to this river, just here and here, if we can, if they'll let us. So let's move him forward a bit. Let's alter that front line so he holds there. Yeah, that's better. Nope, we're going to win that one. We've got 700 defense. Okay, looks like I can push a little bit here, if played right. That should be good. I'm just holding them mostly on this front, because they're all going to run out of supply soon. Non-aggression pact. No. Sorry. I said I'd refuse everything. I'm going to refuse everything. Maybe we want to attack Britain. Who knows? Not soon, but maybe. No quick... Okay, how long until they get there? 3 days, 1 hour, 13 hours. 1 day and 16. How about high strategic redeploy? 9 hours. 13 hours. Okay, I can just get there in time, but I'll be there with really low supply. Really low organization, I mean. How about you come in here and back them up? Yeah, good. Four? Might not be able to hold that. No, we're not going to be able to hold that. Okay, no. Withdraw a line. A bit. These are still hills. Still mountains. They're still good to defend. No, don't push. Don't push. Why can't I tell you to stop pushing? Stop! Thank you. Push a bit here. Oh, no, we can't. No, we can't. No, we can't. Shall I poke out? I mean, they'll probably get killed almost immediately, but oh well. Might as well get some naval experience at least. In fact, let's put them on convoy raiding, that way they'll try and avoid engagements. We're holding pretty well down here. That province looks ripe for the taking, if I had to guess. Let's put those two down there, him in there. Yeah, that looks pretty good to me. This is the area that I'm going to try and take first, because I think that's probably where we'll get the most out of it. Okay, all but one of you deploy over here. You go in there. You guys all push in here. You, I think, can deploy to the main front line. So he's doing reassert eastern claims, which means Lithuania is about to look at this failing German force and go, yeah, I think we should give up Memel. Ooh, someone's deployed themselves over here. No, you don't. Ooh, they're pushing hard in the south. Ooh, that's not good. You can get there in 1 day and a couple of hours. 1 day and 16. 1 day and 21. Ah, okay, so I'll just hold him there for a couple of hours. Now he can get there in 1 day and 14. 1 day and 15. 2, 3, 4. That should do it. 1 day and 11. No, how is his time ticking down? 1 day and 11. 1 day and 10. Yes! Haha! There we go. And that's how you do it. You're needed here, though. So are you. So we lost a little bit of Austria. There were a couple of factories in there that we could have done with, but I think that's okay. Can these guys get there in time? I hope so. Let's switch some of these guys up here and try and push into that province. Oh, we need to put a... put someone in charge of the defence of this port. I think I'll use him. As soon as possible, I need as many men as possible back down here. How are we doing equipment-wise? So we could train a couple more. Let's train up a couple more water divisions. And deploy them straight to the front line. How are you doing skill-wise? He's almost halfway towards offensive doctrine. That's great. Defensive doctrine is useful. Let's see if we can push out a bit. Wherever we can narrow the front line, I want to. Seven of them there, still not winning as handily as I would like. Let's call off some of these attacks. We shouldn't be throwing men away in offensive, so we don't need to. How's the war gone so far, do you reckon, in terms of casualties? It's going 94% in favour of the aggressors. Excuse me? No, it is not. Well, they've lost triple our number of casualties. But, oh, sorry, I've got a bit over there. Oh, well, I think the beginning of that war went mighty well. We're going to call it a part there. Thanks very much for watching. I've been Count Christo. This has been the Polite Poland playthrough, and I'll see you next time. Bye.